Okay, this will make the crema or the sauce, let's say. Right here we have 1/8 ounce of cream cheese, three poblanos that have been toasted and then skinned and deseeded, a little bit of minced garlic, probably three cloves, a quarter of an onion is underneath all that, and some cilantro, about a half of a the amount you buy, I don't know. I don't know what to call it. Anyway, probably a half a cup. Okay. So we're gonna use this ninja, and over here we have milk, and then this is just some of the chicken drippings. Well, it was. It got gelled out, so we'll gotta get a spoon. Anyway, all right. Let's start putting this in there. See what we can get. And as always, don't drop it on the floor. You can if you want, but I wouldn't advise it. Put that in there. There's the cilantro. Put it in there. Might have to do this in batches, but we'll see. I think it might be better. Let's pour half the milk. Like that. And then, like I said, the chicken stock that turned gel. Turn into gel, that's okay. Like that. So I think we'll put this on even though we didn't use all of it, just to finish it here. Okay. Let's see what we got. Oh yeah, beautiful. Well, let me do the rest and we'll proceed, okay? All right, pour it in here, the rest of it, into a saucepan. That's a little more green because I let it go longer. See? Now we're going to cook this for 10 minutes on a little bit less than medium. Since it has milk, we don't want to scald it, all right? Okay, here's the pollo. Just breast meat, like I said. Get this out of here and just simply start putting it in. Just start with that much, see how it goes. Get it in there. We don't want to overcrowd everything. All right. And then back here we have spaghetti that's already pre-cooked, ready to go. It's al dente, so we don't overcook it. We don't want it to be mushy. Just get however much you like. Something like that. Let me turn this around so I could hold it. And then just simply get everybody to know each other as such. And see, we can add more. I just wanted to see how much liquid we had. Looks like we have quite a bit of liquid left, so we can proceed to put some more chicken. Like that, and then some more spaghetti, like that. Even more if we want. I made a lot. I didn't realize how much I made. That's good. Can't say we don't have enough, right? Just get everybody coated. And the more spaghetti, the better. That way it'll soak up the crema verde. There, like that. Yeah, that should be enough, I think. Any more, it's gonna be dry. Not dry, but it's gonna soak it all up. That looks pretty good, actually. But for grins and giggles, we only have a few pieces left. Let's just put the chicken at least. As far as more spaghetti, I hate to waste it, but I can put it in the fridge and just eat it with regular spaghetti sauce later. So I'm gonna shut this off and just let this. It's pretty, everything's cooked. The chicken is just breast meat from one of those chickens you get at the grocery store that are already cooked. I just shredded it up. So anyway, that's how it looks. Let it do its thing. In fact, I'm going to put the lid on it and let it just kind of cook slow, or heat up all the way through, let's say. And then we'll dish some up, shall we? Okay, we got a plate here. Let's just get some. I'm actually going to put a lot because I'm going to eat it. I'm going to eat supper right now. Like such. And this could be a side dish too. But since I put the chicken with it and everything, let's shut this off. Since I put the chicken with it, we'll go ahead and make a mess. I mean, there, that's good. Get out of here. Okay, so we have this now. Put that over there. Let's take some of this queso fresco and simply crumble it on there, see? Crumble it all over. Put a lot, make it worth it. Okay? And then just get some cilantro and kind of garnish it around. It's like that. No biggie, folks. And inside there, there's green spaghetti. Just remember that, okay? Remember that, folks. All right, here it is. There's really nothing we can do except for try it. I don't want to get too big of a piece, but here we go. Yum. Oh, man. Wow. That is killer. Oh, man. Wow. You can taste everything, especially the poblano and the cilantro together with the crema or the cream cheese and the milk, that kind of like crema. And then onion, garlic. Wow. It's magnificent. I don't know, man. I don't know where this has been all my life. I didn't even know about it. In the news channel, the guy was talking about it, that his family in the Rio Grande Valley, they have it every Thanksgiving with their meal as a side dish. So now I added chicken. So I'll put a little recipe in the description for y'all to go by. But it looks like it's very simple. Like if you add a little too much or a little less or a little more of this and that, it's still going to be good. It's one of those kind of like a casserole. So that's killer. Green spaghetti. Who would have thought, hey, I can make this for St. Patrick's Day, right, folks? All right, then. Well, thanks for stopping by. I'm going to try to make more side dishes, getting everybody fired up for Christmas time, okay? All right, well, God bless you. Like, subscribe, comment. And be on the lookout for live videos. And tell all your friends. Share the videos if you can, please. I appreciate it. Until next time, God bless you. And adios, amigos. Hey, thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it. If you like the content here, go ahead and subscribe. All right? Because we'll be having a lot more videos coming up in the future. So thanks again. Tell all your friends. And we'll see you next time.